Talented. You could go to any show that they're in, and they all play a different instrument every show that they do. And again, I'm just so proud of them. How about it, y'all, on the lead guitar from Bremont, Texas, Justin Herzog. Thank you. And over here playing the drums with his feet, acoustic guitar, singing you a little something, running lights and sound over there.
True.
We truly could not have a show without this guy. From Odin, Illinois, Josh Carroll. And George, he likes to give us a hard time about our choreography. That's because he's a dancer.
Oh,
in Mac 7 show, he's a dancer.
I just happen to be a musician with coordination. I wouldn't necessarily call myself a dancer. Although I do know what that's called.
Lockstep or something?
And our fearless leader, you know, George can play more instruments than we can fit on this stage. He's such a great talent. He inspires us every day to follow our dreams, and he's truly a great friend and family to us. From Boston, Massachusetts, George Geiser.
How about the star of the show, the one who picked all of us? Carrie Garrison from Denison, Texas. Bless your heart. Well, I did my best Johnny Cash, my best Shoji Tabuchi, but I tell you what, this guy, when he sings another Johnny Cash train song, you're going to know it's been done right.
Well, I appreciate that. And you know, we are going to do a train song because Johnny Cash, he was born and raised enamored with the hobo lifestyle, and as he got older, went more toward the roughnecking and the prison life. And you can tell about 90% of the songs that he released had something to do with walking on the wild side of life. It's just something that he liked to write about. That was his topics. Well, we're going to do a song that it's his most well-known song. I'm sure you already know what it is, but a little backstory behind it. This song that we're getting ready to do, he actually wrote while he was in the Air Force. It was one of the first songs that he ever wrote. And he didn't do much with it until he auditioned for Sun Records, and Sam Phillips put him on the spot to hear an original song, and Johnny Cash performed this song, actually got signed to his record deal because of it. Wasn't his first release, but it's definitely went down through time as his most famous song. So we're going to go ahead and do it for you, a little traditional version of that old Folsom Prison Blues.
Look what I found, Josh. You're gonna have to hide it a lot better than that. Trust me, George. I got a few places in mind. I hear that train a-coming. It's rolling around the bend. I ain't seen the sunshine since I don't know when. But I'm stuck in Folsom Prison, and time keeps dragging home. And that train keeps rolling on down to San Antonio. When I was just a baby, my mama told me, son, always be a good boy, don't ever play with guns. But I shot a man in Boston just to watch him die. I die. Now every time I see that diver, I hang my head and cry. And die.
Thank you.
I bet there's rich folks eating in a fancy dining car, probably drinking coffee and smoking big cigars. Well, I know I had it coming. I know I can't be free. But those people keep on moving, and that's what tortures me. Well, if they'd free me from this prison, if that railroad train was mine, bet I'd move it on a little farther down the line. I said, far from Folsom Prison, that's where I want you to stay. And I'd let that lonesome whistle blow my blues away.
About my drumming? Does it sound like something or what? It stinks. No. Why do you have a diaper up here anyway?
My grandson's. You never know when you need a diaper.
Well, if you ever stop a show to go change a diaper, that's going to be a first in Branson, I'll tell you that. So that'll make it on the front page of the Independent.
Well, we'll do that tomorrow.
Yeah,
okay. And we need some help.
That's hilarious.
Hey, Eli, how you doing, man?
Hey, Eli, I'm your diaper's up here, buddy.
Yeah, I didn't mean it. Nothing personal, buddy.
Sounds hilarious.
Hey, that's your cousins over here. Eli, you know your cousins. Go introduce them to your mama.
That's funny. Anyway, you know, George.
What?
George and Tammy were not the only married couple in country music.
No way.
It's true. Did you know that Johnny Cash married June Carter?
He did?
Yes.
In a fever?
As a matter of fact, yes. And on that day, it was a scorcher. It was hotter than a pepper sprout. So y'all don't mind, Carrie and I is going to reenact that fateful day. We're going to take a trip down to Jackson, Mississippi. One, two, three, four.
We got married in a fever, hotter than a pepper sprout. We've been talking about Jackson ever since the fire went out. Yeah, I'm going to Jackson. I'm going to mess around. Yeah, I'm going to Jackson. Look out, Jackson town.
Well, come on down to Jackson.
I think I will.
Go ahead.
I'm gonna snowball in Jackson. There's nothing wrong with my hair. I fixed it just for you. When I breeze into that city, people gonna stoop and bow. All them women gonna make me teach them what they don't know how. Yeah, I'm going to Jackson. Turn loose in my goat. Yeah, I'm going to Jackson. Goodbye, that's all she wrote.
They'll laugh at you in Jackson. I'll be dancing on a pony. They'll lead you around like a stallion hound with your tail tucked between your legs. Yeah, I'm going to Jackson. You big talking man. I'll be waiting in Jackson. I'm a J.K. fan.
Well, we got married in a fever, hotter than a pepper sprout. We've been talking about Jackson ever since the fire went out. Yeah, I'm going to Jackson. And that's a fact.
I'm going to.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
No, you're not. I'm going to Jackson. Ain't never coming back.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. right, yeah. This next song we're getting ready to do, it's another duet, and this is our love song that we're going to do for you. Jackson, of course, is not necessarily just because it was recorded by a married couple. Obviously, they were having issues when they recorded that song that day. They were not happy with each other. This next song, these two were happy with each other, so we're going to balance it out for you. It's a beautiful song. It takes me back to when I was a kid. I was about 4 or 5 years old. Mom and Dad had bands growing up all over Southern Illinois. They played. They were so serious that my dad actually built a stage in the garage where they'd rehearse, and that's where I kind of got bit by the music bug. And George was talking about, you know, you grew up in musical families. You never have downtime. You're never bored because somebody's always strumming something, you know. And that's how it was. I was youngest of four, and everybody played something different. So, I mean, it was like the Partridge Family meets the, you know, Duck Dynasty or something. A little bit redneckish in there. So, but it was always a good time. Never a dull moment. But Mom and Dad used to sing this next song. And the cool part is they was about my age now when they used to do it. So I could look back. I remember how Dad looked and how Mom looked. And everybody was young and healthy and happy and stuff. And it's a beautiful song. If anybody is here celebrating an anniversary or something like that, this is a great song to put your arm around your spouse with or hold hands, and it's just a beautiful tune. It's one I'm sure you're going to remember. It's called it's by Waylon Jennings and Jesse Coulter, and it's called Storms Never Last.
Storms never last, do they, baby? God knows our search was for the truth, and the storm brewing now will be the last. Storms never last, do they, baby? Bad times all pass with the wind.
Anybody sound good, huh? So. that's great, hey, man. It's got, I'm glad that I'm part of your band. It makes me happy. But you know, duos weren't just about husband-wife teams in country music. There's a lot of unlucky pairings actually became quite successful. A couple I like to talk about, number one of the Judds. Where are you going, Joy?
I'm
going to
go get a different guitar. I'm going on the bus.
Oh, you're going to go out to the bus? Okay, cool. Yeah, y'all might not know, we have a tour bus sitting out back, actually. Today, after this show, we embark on our first European tour. So, y'all got some life jackets, right? But the Judds, great mother-daughter team, great harmonies. Awesome. But when they first came out, the critics said that they didn't possess the proper dynamic to appeal to country music fans, and the Judds answered back with about 15 years of number one hits. Second were Brooks and Dunn. They were two individual artists signed with the same record label, and they were getting ready to be dropped because they couldn't get a hit on the radio. And they had the same manager that believed in them so much, he put his own money up front to form the duo, and upon release of their first album, guess what? The critics came out and said if they can't make it as individual artists, they'll never make it as a duo. Well, they just came out of retirement last week. I never even knew they went into retirement because every time you turn on an award show, they're up there playing. They've been around for over 25 years, and they have outsold every other duo in recorded music history. So you never know what you're going to get. But a lot of that stems from the concept of those project albums of the 70s and 80s. A couple of them that we all talk, that we all know is the Highwaymen. We all know that one, right? And then we have the Outlaws. So there's a lot of these individual artists that got together and they were buddies and they made these records that went legendary overnight. Well, we're going to branch off that and I'm going to do my best Waylon Jennings. And George, you back off the bus yet? Oh my goodness, what do you got?
Tell me when.
You're good. No, I fixed it.
I got me a little guitar I found in a pawn shop in Chicago. Not really. It was a pawn shop in Branson. And that is the truth. And as soon as I seen it, I knew I needed to have it because it had already had the Willie Nelson bling all over it. And boy, I remember the first time my dad brought that Redheaded Stranger album back from the music store. I sat around, I learned every song on that. I was a kid, I'd sing, "All the Redheaded Stranger from Blue Rock, Montana, rode into town one day." That sounds pretty good. Sounds like the Chipmunks. I mean, my part. You guys sound great. But anyway, yeah. But a poor guy come to town. I think he was going to have his own music Willie Nelson show, and it didn't work out quite that well. Sometimes it takes a little while. Took me 30 years to get my show.
Overnight success, ladies and gentlemen.
So anyway, no, I'll do my best to see what I can do with Willie and you. You, I know you got that Waylon handled pretty good.
Yeah. All right, let's do it. Let's do a little Good Hearted Woman. Here we go. One, two, three, four.
A long time forgotten, dreams that just fell by the way. The good life he promised ain't what she's living today. Come on, Willie.
Oh, no, she never complains about the bad things, the bad times she's done for. She just talks about the good times and all the good times. Oh.
She's a good-hearted woman and loves always a good time and man. Loves him in spite of those wicked ways that she don't understand. There's tears and laughter, they'll pass through this world hand in hand.
I'll hide the moon.
She's a good-hearted woman, living a good time and man. I'm not worried about the moon. Well, she's a good-hearted woman, living a good time and man.
Thank you. I got to go back out the bus. No. I think I left something burning on. I don't care. You're going to wait till after the show.
Well, no, truth is, I think I left all that nonsense out. When I was a child, I did some childish things. And boy, I sure hope my mom never looks behind the bookcase at the house. Anyway, no, George Jones, you know, he come to his senses. In 99, he hit that bridge embankment and should have killed him, you know. He'd been sober for almost a decade, and he had every internal injury pretty much possible. And he got so depressed, he wouldn't talk to anybody but Vessel Goodman of the Happy Goodmans. And she dropped what she was doing and
come to the hospital and was praying over him, you know, and just tears was rolling out both sides of his eyes. And he actually grew up in the church. He learned his first guitar chords he learned from a guitar player at the church. His wife, his mom was a church pianist. You might not know this about Waylon. He had studied for the ministry as well, a Church of Christ preacher. And anyway, we all kind of get a little outside at times, you know. It's how you finish that matters. And George Jones, when he did finally get it right, I've got to finish the story. He walked out of the hospital on his own 19 days later. And we talk about that alone is a miracle. But he threw down the cigarettes and all the other vices that he leaned on, you know. And he got back to his roots like Johnny did in Waylon. And but George Jones, you know, he was singing good songs like What My Woman Can't Do Can't Be Done, and Put a Golden Band on the Right Left Hand This Time, Once You've Had the Best. Well, there's a ton of them. They would edify his wife, Nancy. And we want to do that at this time. It's called What My Woman Can't Do Can't Be Done.
3, 4, 1. What my woman can't do can't be done. It amazes me how she can change my mind. When it seems to be impossible, she can do it every time. And the way she always loves me, she's got that down perfect too. I keep asking myself what it is the lady can't do. She brightens any room she walks inside, and the way she's always smiling, you never think she ever cries. She still looks as young and pretty as she did the day we met. And if there's one thing bad about her, I ain't found it yet. What it is my woman can't do can't be done. If there's ever been a darling, I've got one. She beats all I've ever seen. She's the champion of our team. Oh, what my woman can't do can't be done. No, what my woman can't do can't be done.
Hey, Eli, will you come up here and help me sing Rocking Chair? This is the point in the show where I talk about our set here. It belonged to my neighbor across the street. His name's Leo Davis. And him and his wife, Barb, they were married 60-plus years. He was 3rd Day Normandy, part of the Army. That's most of the stuff up there, including the picture. That's his Army picture. When he came back from the war, he married his childhood sweetheart. And you can just sit on the couch here and grab that mandolin. We'll get you hooked up with a microphone. We'll get Justin's microphone for you here in a minute. He come back from the war, and come on up here. You know, he married his childhood sweetheart. They were married 61 plus years. He worked for the same company all his life, a power company up in Iowa. And when it come time to retire, he picked Branson of all places to retire. He loved the music down here, the people and the scenery. And when he moved into our little subdivision, it was just a dirt road. And in fact of the matter, it was still a dirt road when we moved there, but he had been there quite a while before we got there. And here about 3 years ago, his wife passed away. And we did like any neighbor would do. You know, we started bringing over hot meals at night, and we kind of check up on them at night. And he didn't last long without Barbara. She was the driving force, I think, in his life. And He lasted almost a year, and when his granddaughter come down from Iowa to settle things up, she took what she wanted and got the house ready for sale, and she knew I was taking care of him, and anything that I wanted, he was they said go over there and get. Well, I have two daughters. This one, my one daughter, yeah, and Rachel, and is that gonna work? what are you gonna sing today, buddy? You gonna sing some? Who are you gonna sing today?
Yeah.
Yeah. Who do you like in the way of singers? You like Johnny Cash or George Jones?
Yeah.
Which one?
John.
Thank you. Just let it be known this is a George Jones show. So anyway, she said anything I wanted to remember Leo by. I just helped myself have two daughters and only one rocking chair. So I was just elated when that rocking chair was still there, and she left pictures on the wall. I didn't want them to wind up in the trash, and that family Bible there, it's dated 1946, got their genealogy and all that. I don't have a treasure like that. Well, I do. I just can't play it every day because I don't trust myself with it. But anyway, I'd like to dedicate this, if you don't mind, to my good neighbor Leo Davis and Barbara. Yeah, I don't need your rocking chair because I got Leo's right over there. I don't need your rocking chair. Jeff and tall boy, you better care. Still got me on in my bag. And this whole hair don't need a bag. And I do a little rocking on the stage. You're gonna put a little possum in a cage. Well, my body's older, but it ain't in pain. And no, and I don't need to rock and chair. Retirement don't fit in my plan. The seat I'm gonna stand. Well, an Eskimo needs a Frigidaire. Oh, I thought I got a nature rocking chair. Only I don't need your rocking chair.
Yes, he needs a rocking chair.
You're a tall and better care.
You're a tall and better care.
Still got neon in my brain.
He's got neon in his brain.
This whole man don't need a thing.
Meet your grandpa, George.
Twice. And I do a little rock.
He can't rock much on that stage.
Put a
little
possum in a cage. Leg George out of his cage. My body's older, but it ain't
impaired.
His
body is old
and it is impaired.
I don't need
your
rocking chair.
That's right, folks. Not today, anyway.
Woo!
Out of big hand for Eli. Eli got it. Yeah. Well,
that was a good idea.
Well, thank you.
That was Eli's idea. He gave him
Eli's idea.
He said, hey, let's make on Grandpa.
That's what he said.
Well, okay. I believe that. You can't fool me. I think you're just trying to blame it on the new kid.
Well, of course.
It took us a while, but we finally figured it out. If you blame it on the last person that got fired, there was kind of no recourse. So,
fired, we wouldn't have a show left.
that's true enough. That's true enough. Well, I think I pay for this abuse.
Yeah, now we know you're kidding. Carrie, you get paid?
Of course.
George, you told me this was an internship.
I might have let that slip.
Oh my gosh,
could you bail me out here?
Oh, my goodness.
I'm going to go buy a ticket to get in here.
George,
I'll try you're still under your probationary period.
I'll try to help you out. Change the subject. As George mentioned earlier, a lot of the artists that we've covered this morning have so many things in common. They're incredible, unforgettable music. Their wild and crazy ways. The women that help pick them up from their hard times. But most importantly, their deep abiding faith in our Lord Jesus Christ. We are so blessed that in Branson and in this beautiful theater that we can acknowledge our faith. And we would love to do that now by doing a couple gospel songs for you. As I went down in the river to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear a robe and crown, good Lord, show me the way.
to pray, studying about that good old way, and to shall wear a robe and crown. Good Lord, show me the way. Oh, brothers, let's go down, let's go down, come on down. Oh, brothers, let's go down, down in the river to pray. As I went down in the river to pray, studying about that good old way, and to shall wear a robe and crown. Good Lord, show me the way.
Rock of ages, rock of ages, cleft for me.
That song was written by Willie Nelson. Probably every country artist has had a record out on it. Bush George Jones did the best job. And it's called The Family Bible. I know he knows this one too. Oh, there's a family Bible the table. Its page is worn and hard to read, but that family Bible on the table, oh, will ever be my key to memory. At the close of day, when work was over, and when the evening meal was done, my dad would read to us from the family Bible, and we count our many blessings one. And I can see us sitting around the table. We're from the family Bible Dad would read. And I can hear my mother softly singing, Rock of Ages, rock. This old world of ours is full of troubles, and this old world would also better be if we find more Bibles on the table, and mother singing, Rock of Ages, clap for me. And I can see us sitting around the table. Singing, Rock of Ages, You know, George Jones, when he started losing all his buddies, he went in and recorded a song called "Who's Gonna Fill Their Shoes." And as soon as I heard it, I actually woke up one night. I was trying to figure out how he was gonna build a show. And I sat up in bed one night, and "Who's Gonna Fill Their Shoes?" It talks about all those great singers and the great music at the time. Basically, wrote this show in about 10 minutes on a piece of paper. I just had to fill in the blanks for these guys. And this old world is full of singers, but you know, just a few are chosen to tear your heart up when they sing. And imagine life without all of your radio heroes. I like the outlaw that flows through Jesse's dream. You know, they'll never be another. I'm red-headed stranger, the man in black and Folsom Prison blues. Great job, Johnny.
Yeah.
An Aroki from Muskogee. And hello, darling. Lord, I wonder who's gonna fill their shoes. Who's gonna fill their shoes? And who's gonna stand that tall? And who's gonna play the opera and the Wabash Cannonball? And who's gonna give their heart and soul to get to me? Lord, I wonder who's gonna fill their shoes. Yes, I'm wondering who's gonna fill their shoes.
Thank you. God bless you. If you get a chance, spread the word. If you got any extra time, tell them about our little show here. We need all the help we can get. You can Facebook friends and George Jones and friends. How about another hand for our star here, Eli Geiser. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, George Geiser.
Thank you. Well, I don't need your rocking chair.
You gonna go up here and shake and howdy with me, buddy?